Do you need to make personal, individual, financial statements? Well, in that case, you should start by looking at your profit and loss. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Profit and loss statement, sometimes called the income statement, shows how well you operated regarding how much of your earned money you were able to keep. It shows how well you did during a specific period of time. QuickBooks gives you the ability to compare profit and loss statements of different time periods. You can judge your progress regarding how you are operating financially from one time period compared to another time period. For example, let's compare how well we did in the first 2 months, meaning January and February, compared to how well we did during the next 2 months, March and April. Well, what I've done here in QuickBooks Online is open to the dashboard as I log in. Now, we click Reports and Profit and Loss. It's in the Custom Report section, Profit and Loss. Now, before we set the from date and the to date, we have to duplicate this tab up here. And you'll notice that this time I included the browser tabs in the video, in the screen capture, so that I can show you what to do. So after you open your profit and loss the way we memorized it before with all dates, you would then go to the tab, and most browsers work this way. I'm using Firefox, but most browsers, if you click on the tab and you right-click and then you click Duplicate Tab, you should get a duplicate of the window you were in if you were using QuickBooks Online and running the profit and loss. Now, notice when I click from one tab to the other, you can see that both of them have the same content. But let's click the tab on the left. Now, first, let's temporarily remove the left panel of menu choices by clicking the three lines here in the top left of the report window. Click, and the left panel menu collapses. Now let's go to the other tab, click the other tab, click the three lines, and collapse it. This way we can more clearly see our profit and loss. Now when we click the left tab, let's make that one January and February. The way to do that is to click the pull down arrow and then go to custom, which is the second choice down. Then click the calendar and put January 1. Click the other calendar and put February 28. Then click run the report. Now you can see this is the total of the income category for all transactions during January and February. And this is the total of the expense category for all the expense transactions that were recorded with dates during January and February. And this is the net income, the result of how well you earned and how well you saved during those 2 months. Now let's click the other tab and do the same thing. Click the pull-down menu and choose custom. And then there, choose March 1 to April 30th. Then click Run Report. Now you can see this is the total of the income category for March and April, and this is the total of the expense category for March and April. And if you click the left tab and the right tab, you should be able to compare any two time periods you want regarding how well you did and how well you saved. Now, if you click here, you can see that you only earned $4,000 worth of income during January and February, but on the other hand, you had much lower expenses. And that's why your net income is $3,250. Between March and April, you had much more income, and that sounds good, but you had much more expenses. And unfortunately, you can see that the increase in your expenses was more than the increase in your income. So the actual net income for the second 2 months is more than the net income from the first 2 months. And line by line, you can compare what the reason was and the difference you paid and the difference in what you received in income for those two separate time periods. In our previous video, we discussed the idea of net income from operations. This is how well you did regarding income and expenses that relate to how you operate, or in the case of an individual, how well you're making a living regarding how much you're earning compared to how much you're able to save. Sometimes your income changes for a reason that has nothing to do with your normal income and expenses. If something like that happens to you, you should be able to see your normal income or normal profit from your normal operations and be able to compare that to your overall net income that includes the rare and unusual items of income or expense. And anytime you have an other income or other expense type of unusual situation, it will show up on the profit and loss below the normal net income from operations. This way, you can see the normal operating income and the overall net income in the same place. So let's keep comparing these two income statements after this example issue. Let's imagine back on January 3rd, we received a gift of $7,000. The money was deposited to Chase Bank, and this is not a reoccurring source of income, obviously. It's not really reflective of how efficiently you operated. If it's not in your control, it should be put in the chart of accounts as other income. So, I suggest that you close one of the two tabs if you're not comparing financial statements. Then click the three lines to bring back the left panel. Then scroll down to Accounting, Chart of Accounts. Now we have to click New to add a new account in the Chart of Accounts, and the account type is not income, it's down here, Other Income. And there are detailed types for other income. The most appropriate in this case would be other miscellaneous income, and we will put gift income, capital letters. Okay. Click save and close, and now we're ready to record January 3rd's gift. We know that it was recorded in the Chase Bank account. So in the row of Chase Bank, click View Register, and we're going to add a deposit. So in the pull down, make sure you're choosing deposit, and we put the date, a transaction we missed back on January 3rd, and the account that we put is the account that we just created, the only account in the category of other income, gift income. Now, this was a deposit of $7,000. And that's all you have to do. You have to scroll to the bottom to scroll to the right to be able to click Save. And now let's go back to the profit and loss. Reports, profit and loss, and of course, we'll modify the dates, custom, January 1, to January February 28 and click Run Report, and you can see that the gift income comes under the net operating income. So as far as earning and saving, we still have the same result, but we also have this gift income that was out of our control that made our overall income for those 2 months increase greatly. Now let's compare that to our second example. Let's imagine on March 5th, 2021, someone broke in at night and stole $500 from the cash box. That would be an other expense type of account, and it would be loss on theft, and this is how you would record it. You know, the cash on hand is the account that changed. So you click Accounting, Chart of Accounts, and in the row of cash on hand, click View Register. Now, you're not adding a deposit. This is obviously an expense, but it's an other expense, and we did not yet add that other expense to the chart of accounts. But that's okay, because when you click the account pull down in the transaction, you can add an account at the moment you make the transaction. You go to the top of the scroll bar and click Add New, and you're in the Add New Account window just as you would be as if you came there from the chart of accounts. Now this is obviously an other expense type of account because it is not within your control and it's not part of your net income from operations. The detail type, however, can be just other miscellaneous expense. That would be the most appropriate in this case, and the name of it will be loss on theft. Click Save and Close. Now, the amount obviously must be in the payment column of $500, and the date that the money was taken, I believe, was March 5th. So we go to March 5th. And we now have to scroll to the right to be able to click Save. Now, let's take a look at the profit and loss. Reports, profit and loss. Now we have to set the date range to the later date range. Custom, March 1 to April 30, because that's the other date range we are comparing, and click Run Report. And now you can see that this date range did not have the gain on the gift income, but this time period did have the loss on theft. And notice the loss on theft comes under the net operating income because it's not in your control and it does not reflect how much you've earned and how well you saved. To close, let's compare this to the earlier time period again to see how the bottom looks different. Right-click the tab and click Duplicate Tab. And then, of course, change the time period of the second tab to January 1 to February 28. Then click Run Report. So in the first 2 months, under net operating income, you had gift income of $7,000. And in the latter 2 months, under net operating income, you had loss on theft of $500. And one only appears in one profit and loss and the other appears in the other profit and loss because they happened in two separate time periods.